As part of the .NET MAUI Community Toolkit, we've now released version 1.0 of the camera view. In this video, we're going to see what you can do with it. You might still know the camera view from back when it was implemented in the Xamarin Community Toolkit. We've had it there, and truth be told, it wasn't always super stable. So for the .NET MAUI Community Toolkit, we've rebuilt it from the ground up, and now we have this new camera view version 1.0 as a separate package. And actually, the separate package is called .camera, not camera view, so that we have the ability, the possibility in the future to add more camera stuff in there and not be tied to just the camera view. And I say we implemented it, but this is actually an amazing story. There has been a company out there that has donated their time. An employee of them was like, hey, we need this camera view for our project. We love the .NET MAUI Community Toolkit and the whole community as a whole. We want to do something back, and instead of donating money, they wanted to donate back in time. So they were like, we have this camera view implementation already. We want to give that to you. We want to work together with you to implement that in the .NET MAUI Community Toolkit. So that's what we did. We collaborated, and now we have the result of that, camera view version 1. Let's go check it out. Okay, here in Visual Studio 2022, I have a new .NET MAUI project, as you're used to from my videos, and we're going to add the camera view to this. So first, let's go to our Solution Explorer to actually install the NuGet package right here. I'm going to click my project node and then select Manage NuGet Packages. Then you'll end up in the NuGet browser. Of course, you can do this from Visual Studio Code, on Windows, on Mac, whatever you want. We have NuGet support for Visual Studio Code now as well, so that's super, super cool. So you can install it through that, or just add the csproj file at the little node right there. And you're going to look for CommunityToolkit.Maui, because we have several, .camera. Like I said, it's going to be camera, just camera. It's just been released version 1.0.2 because we found some little bugs in there already. So that's at the time of recording the latest version. And we named it camera because we can add like all kinds of cool stuff in here, right? You can probably imagine what that would look like. So we're not just tied to the view, but we can do other things with the camera. But the camera view is definitely in there. So we're going to install that. We're going to review the licenses. We're going to review the extra dependencies that's coming in here. And you can see Android is always very eager to bring in a lot of dependencies, and that's also the reason why we made this a separate package, so that we don't force all these dependencies on everyone. Whenever it's installed, you will see, you will get a little readme right here that will tell you how to get started. You probably just want to copy this line, use MAUI Community Toolkit camera, right? So that's the line that we need to add to our MAUI program. And then we can start using it in our XAML. And we don't need to forget the permissions that we need to add for the camera, of course. So let's start with the MAUI program first. Go to the Solution Explorer again, go to the MAUI program. And then here on our builder, you can see we have this little helper right here that will say, hey, you need to initialize this line. Actually, it's not showing me. Oh, there we go. No, it's not. It's not really showing me in the IntelliSense right here. So that might be another bug we need to fix. But it's complaining because we don't have the initializer for the MAUI camera. So let's just do that. Use MAUI Community Toolkit camera. And then it will automatically bring in using CommunityToolkit.Maui here in the top. If it doesn't do that, just add it manually and you will be ready to go. Okay, perfect. Now, the other thing, well, like I said, we need to do the permissions, right? So I'm going to show you on Android today. I will make sure that all the sample code on the repository that will be published under the video below in the description, it will also have the right permissions in the info plist for like macOS. And if something is needed on Windows, we have all the documentation on learn.microsoft.com. Link can also be found down below. All the permissions and everything that's needed will be in there as well. I'm just going to show you for Android right now. So let's go back to our Solution Explorer again, go to the platforms folder, then Android, and then find our Android manifest. Actually, let me just double click it. We'll get the nice graphical editor right here, which lets you set a couple of things. Also the required permissions right here. And we're going to search for camera. So scroll, 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 scroll. There we go. See, so we have camera in here. boom, click that, and it should bring in the camera permission for our application. If you want to do it manually, you can right-click on this XML file, you can do open with, and then the XML editor, and you will see that the camera was added right here. You can also do it manually if that's what you want. Same thing for iOS, Solution Explorer, go to the iOS folder or Mac Catalyst. The info plist, I don't think we have the permissions in the graphical editor, so do again open with XML text editor, and you will add the right key right here. Add a little description so that your user knows why you want to use the camera, and you'll be good to go for iOS and Mac Catalyst as well. So, okay, we got that. Let's go quickly back to the README because we need this XML NS toolkit. I always keep forgetting like what the actual URL is, so let's just copy that, and then we can close the README, and we can close the NuGet browser right here, and then we can go to our mainpage.xaml. In which we're going to add the camera view. So we have this XMLNSX for all the MAUI types right here, and then I'm going to add the XMLNS toolkit so that we have all the toolkit types in here. In this case, only the camera stuff. But if you would add like the other MAUI community toolkits, it would be all just this line. No need to have like multiple XML namespaces in here, just this one line. And I'm going to actually keep the image. Let's keep it the source with the .NET bar. That's fine. Height request is also fine. Semantic properties. I'm going to remove that because it's not going to make any sense for what I'm going to do. And I want to give it a little X name in here. I'm not going to use MVVM. Of course, if you want to be a clean developer, you probably want to use MVVM, but I'll get to that in a minute. For now, I'm going to do it with the code behind. So let's name this my image, and then the label, I'll add a new button later. I'm just going to add the camera view right here. So I have this image with the .NET bot, and then underneath, I'm going to add the camera view. We're going to use the toolkit prefix, and then we have the camera view. That's it. That's how you import the camera view. It's going to show up nicely now. So there we have it. And of course, there is like a good number of events, commands, properties, everything is in here. So what do you think of like the flash mode, right? We can set that. Or the zoom factor, you can do that. Or what else do we have? Like, let's scroll through here. We have events is enabled, obviously. Image capture resolution. So you can set the resolution for the image that you're going to capture. And you can also request from the device what resolutions are available, what cameras are available. So very, very cool stuff. Events for whenever a media is captured, a media capture has failed. So all kinds of things are in here that you can use. Also, the selected camera is important. I'll get to that in a minute. You can switch between the cameras for Windows, the different cameras, but also like on a mobile device, usually like the back or the front, right? You can select that one. So we'll get to that in a minute as well. If we just do this, it's going to use the default camera, which is usually the rear one, but the device can kind of like decide. So that's what we are going to have a look at as well. Let's give this an X name as well of my camera, just so that we can reference it in our code behind as well. And then what we want to do is kind of like have the media captured. So the way this works, you want to have this event for whenever the media is captured. So we need a button to capture the media, obviously, so that we are going to implement that. But also then whenever that happens, that doesn't return something in itself. You will have to go through like the media captured event. And that is also kind of like where I didn't decide to implement this through MVVM because we have a kind of like weird bug, if you will. I'm going to discuss this with the team because you can use a command. We actually have like commands, right? Oops, yeah, command should be in here. Why is it not showing? It's not showing for some reason. Capture, resolution. No, there should be commands in here, but I can't find it right now. And you can use commands to actually capture the image as well and do other things. But you will still have to kind of like capture this event to get the actual media. And that's kind of funny because now you're half using MVVM and the other half is still events. So there's something wrong there. I'm going to talk to the team and see how we can make that better. So we're going to use events right here just to get you started with this. We should have this event right now. I'm going to remove all of this old code for the old button that we have here. We don't need that anymore. And now we have this media captured thing. And you can see we have these event arcs. And in the event arcs, we have e.media. And that's going to be a stream with the media that we have. So whenever you get that, you can show it in an image, which is what we are going to do. You can send it to your backend. You can do all kinds of things. You can save it to the file system if that's what you want. You can do all these things. So let's add a little button too. This is still a vertical stack layout, right? I left that in place, so it's just going to stack it all on top of each other. Let's add a button here. The text is going to be smile because we're going to take a picture, right? So we need to smile. And then we're going to have the clicked event, new event handler, and we need this one. Okay, so now we have a new event handler too. We can reference the camera view with my camera. So in the event handler here, I can say my camera dot, my IntelliSense is not really helping me here today. Capture media, I think. Capture media. Maybe I need to do a build and it will pick up on my changes right here. Capture, oh, I think it's capture image. There we go. Now it seems the IntelliSense, we got it all here. Capture image. And this actually wants a cancellation token. And if you've been watching my channel since longer times, then you probably know that I've been promising a cancellation token. It's almost becoming a running gag now. Cancellation token video for a while. So if that's still something that you want, let me know down in the comments. This might be a nice example, actually. So capture image, and here I'm going to do cancellation token. We need to provide it, but I'm going to do cancellation token dot none. Whenever you don't want to really cancel it, you can just do cancellation token none. And here we probably want to do async because it's an async call, so we can do await. And you want to make sure whenever we do void, you want to wrap it in a try catch so that something, whenever something goes wrong, actually get the exception, because right now the way I'm doing this, it's going to get swallowed, right? So that's not something that you want to do in your real production code. This is sample code. I can get away with it. Okay, so now we have that. And whenever the image is captured, we are going to come into this event, right? So we can do things here. And now I can say my image.source is image source dot from stream. And I can just say, hey, I want to have this it wasn't e.image stream, it was e.media, but that's actually a stream, right? We can inspect that. You can see, like, hey, this is a stream. So this should work. Although I already, of course, prepared this on beforehand, and just to not waste your time with showing you an error, we want to do this from the UI thread, because this event is raised from a background thread, right? That happens with events. And this needs to happen on the UI thread to actually update the image. So what you want to do there is do dispatcher dot, you can do it the right way, right? Like, is dispatch required, right? That's something we can kind of like request from our application. Hey, do we need to run this on the UI thread, yes or no? And then whenever we do, you want to do dispatcher dot dispatch, or you can do dispatch async. I can just do dispatch right here, and we can say, what action do you want to dispatch? Well, I want to do set this source thing right here. So just copy that, put that in here, and now it's going to nicely update it from the UI thread, and everything will be okay. No exceptions will be thrown. And let's just return here so that, you know, we've done this on the UI thread now. And whenever this is not needed, we can still update it, right? But now we can do it from the UI thread. I don't think that will happen in this case, but just to make sure that we're not blocking the UI thread unnecessarily. So let's just do it like this. Obviously, if you want to do this in real code, you don't want to duplicate this and put it in its own method or something like that. But again, sample code, I can get away with it. Okay. So I think whenever we do this, we should see kind of like the first things of our camera view. So let's just run it. I have a physical Android device right here. I'm mirroring the screen with an application that's built into Windows called Phone Link, which is super cool. You can get all kinds of like your Android notifications, all that stuff on your Windows desktop, but only for specific Android devices. So go check it out. But you can also cast your screen. So any moment now, the application will come up here and we'll see the first camera view with just a few lines of code implemented in our .NET MAUI application. And the app is being deployed. We can see the splash screen coming up here. So in a minute, we should see also, of course, like the permission. So that is built in. You don't need to request the permissions manually if that's what you need. It will do that automatically. So let's just say, okay, only this time. And you can see, hey, there's my camera. We can see infinite race cars right here and all my code, a little bit like behind the scenes right here. And we can scroll a little bit down and we can say smile, right? So if I click the smile button, it should capture the image, and you can see the image updating there at the top with the image that we still have in there. So, okay, this is working perfectly. Now let's see what kind of like other options we still have here, just to give you a sense of what you can implement more. So if you want to change the selected camera, there is the iCamera provider that's automatically registered in the dependency injection container. So you can do iCamera provider, camera provider. And on that, we can get like the available camera. So you can do refresh available cameras. You need to do that first. It will refresh like the list of cameras that's in here. And then you can query this available cameras collection right here. And whenever we kind of like simulate that I have a thing in here, you can say, hey, device ID, the name is flash supported, yes or no. So you can get a couple of things, minimum zoom factor, maximum zoom factor, position, supported resolution. So you can get all this data from the cameras right here. And it's a little bit too much. This video will become too long. If this is something that you're interested in selecting different cameras, let me know down in the comments below and I will make a follow-up video on how to actually do that. For now, I'm going to skip over it and just set a couple of properties to show you what this can do. So let's go back to my example. Let's add some other buttons. Let's add two. Let's do like flash. So I'm going to toggle the flash right here. Give me a new event handler for that. And the other thing is let's do some zoom, right? Zoom is always cool too. And do another new event handler. Okay, flash and zoom. So let's just implement those. And right here, button one click, that was the flash. So I'm gonna say my camera dot flash mode is flash mode on or off. My camera, yeah, this seems all right. AI, let's do it. Thank you, Copilot. And I think I need to import a using statement here, using CommunityToolkit.Maui.Core.Primitives. That's kind of like where the enums and all this stuff lives. So let's just do that. And it will import this using here right at the top. So it will now recognize all these types here. And whenever it's kind of like off, it turns it to on and otherwise, right? So this toggles the camera flash mode. We'll see that in a live demo in a little bit. And the other thing was the zoom. So let's do my camera.zoom factor, okay? Zoom factor. Well, let's do it otherwise. Let's do it pluses 0, 1. This doesn't look correct. Okay, double to a float. Okay, let's fix that. Let's make it a float. Okay, so now whenever I press that button, it keeps zooming in, right? So we don't really have a zoom out button. You probably want to make it a slider or something. You're probably a better designer than I am. You know me, I love minimalistic designs. So you probably want to do something better here. But for now, this is going to work. It's going to show you that it actually zooms in. So let's deploy this again. And what we can do now is enable the flash and enable the zoom. And we are going to take a little bit of more pictures. So let's bring up the screen mirroring again right here. You can see the application is already being deployed again. And now we have a couple of extra buttons. So, okay, while using the app, that's fine. I'm not gonna give permission like all the time. You can see my Kindle that's charging right here so I can read some more books and learn some more. And now I have smile, I have flash, and I have zoom. So let's toggle the flash. There's no immediate feedback for that. But whenever I press smile now, you can probably see it in the camera, in the little camera there here in the corner, you can see that the flash is coming up, right? So we have a little flash going on here. And I can also do zoom. So if I click zoom, 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 you can actually see the zoom go in. And if I click flash again, it will disable the flash again. And I can do click smile and it will again update the picture here at the top, right? So with just a few lines of code, I've now implemented a camera view inside of this .NET MAUI application. Like I already mentioned a little bit, this is also available on Windows, on iOS, on Mac Catalyst. Check out the documentation, which is linked below, as well as the sample repository that I updated with all the permissions that are needed, which is a sample that you can deploy to your iOS device as well, if that's what you want. Thank you so much, Esri, and personally, Zitao, for making this possible. Esri is the company that kind of like generously donated their time in the form of Zitao, who has been working together with us, the .NET MAUI Community Toolkit team, to actually implement this feature, write it from the ground up again, and work together with us and have a lot of patience while we go through the reviews as time permits us. So really, really thank you. This has been amazing, and I'm sure that everyone will be super happy to actually work with this and implement this. Let me know down in the comments what you're creating with this, what you want to see next for the camera view or something else. And actually, I mentioned it already. Let me know if you want to know more about that camera provider, but I couldn't really help myself, so I recorded that video as well. You can check it out right here, and I will see you for that one.